up your YouTube, search for Stukely Meadows. Watch on your big screen. Get yourself comfy, this could take a while. What a happy scene. Something new every day for your long-term memory. This is so exciting, it is nearly time for a Stukely assembly. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our Friday retrieval assembly. For each other, we. Every day, we. To improve, we. Together, we will. Every single Stukely day, we focus on. Our Stukely motto is. Our Stukely curriculum is, and four words that make the magic happen. Yes, they do. Okay, first of all, I never do a shout out at the start, but I am today. Shout out to Willow Class, who are all doing remote learning for the next few days. Hey, Willow Class, I hoped that you would be in school doing this with Mrs. Boswell and getting out your learning logs and retrieving, but you're at home doing it. Hope you're all doing okay. Hope you're busy with the jobs that you've been given and the learning that you've got. Email Mrs. Boswell, email us if you need us, ring the office if you need to with your families, but I hope you're working hard and I hope you're ready and pumped for retrieval assembly today. Talking of being pumped for assembly, let's find out what our regular two are up to. Hey, hello, Mr. Smith.
Good afternoon, Mr. Seaman.
How are we feeling about the big one?
I have looked at all those questions. Fantastic question. It's a real challenge this week.
Out of all the year groups, Mr. Smith, who do you think is going to get the most out of the retrieval assembly?
Oh, it's definitely year three.
Oh, it will have to be. Has to be year three. Yeah. Oh, it's Mrs. Cooper.
Hi.
Hello, Mrs. Cooper. Tell me about your excitement for Friday's retrieval assembly.
Best day of the week.
After Friday, which is the second best day of the week?
Wednesday.
And why?
Don't I just like Wednesday?
Oh, love a Wednesday! Oh, it's always a pleasure going to see what those two guys are up to. Now, before we get ready to retrieve, we've got the usual assembly agenda today. Can I just warn you now, the phone calls bit is not an actual phone call, it's the aftermath from last week's phone call. It is an incredible collection of photographs of Mrs. Campbell and her family dressed up as Evel Knievel. I have to say, it's made me smile ever since I first saw it nearly 24 hours ago. So there's a treat coming up. Right, learning logs, please don't race ahead because we're going a bit different today. We're doing things a bit differently today. Here we go. Okay, learning log, we're on page 26 and 27. Look what I've done. I have read all these days, but Wednesday, Mr. Gum, the book ended with Jake surviving, full stop. It was a shame that there was little detail about Mr. Gum. That's my opinion. I was disappointed with that. I've done most of my reading this week. I've done a couple of rock stars. That means I won't be missing my own time next week. Come on now. Page 27, please watch carefully because I'm going to go a bit of an alternative route. Everybody, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is important now. Year 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You are going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 boxes, 5 lines, sorry. Then you're going to put a 0. You're going to leave a gap before the 0. It's important. Off you go.
Yeah.
Yes, I know what you're thinking. Where's the evil Knievel outfit? Unfortunately, I lent most of it to the Campbell family and they've still got it. They don't want to give it back. And Mr. Smith has also got some evil Knievel gear to enjoy on a Friday. So I'm having a break this week. Feels less clammy, if I'm honest. Now, you've got your learning logs ready. Foundation are ready to talk and discuss their answers. Year one, you do a bit of chat before you write as well. I've got my book. Let's do this. Hi, Foundation. We've got six questions for you to retrieve. Six things for you to remember, to go into your memory and bring them back from the last week or so. I hope you're ready. Question number one. What are these tricky troll words? I'm going to show you some words and you're hopefully going to say them for me. Should do this professionally. Well done, everyone. Question number two. Can you blend these words? Can you blend them? Listen to my sounds. F-O-K. Next one. Next one. Sorry, Foundation teachers, that was dreadful. Well done, children, for working that out. Right, number three. This is a great question. Which of these people is tallest? Who is the tallest? Mrs. Booth, Roman, or Miss Slipper? Question number four. Can you tell me as many light sources as you can? Think of as many as you can as a class. Go! Question number five. Which of these are natural life sources? We've got sun, light bulb, torch, and lightning. Which ones are natural? Question number six. Can you do this adding? I'm going to show you some adding. Here's the first one. The next one. And the last one. I think I've been a bit mean here. Well done, Foundation Stage. Another great week. Have a good weekend. I'll see you soon. Hello, Year One. Back on the retrieval again. I hope your books are ready. I hope you've got a nice sharp pencil. Listen up, here we go. Number one, 2D shapes. You've been doing this. Which 2D shape has got two long sides and two shorter sides? Write it down, please. Question number two, please spell the word these. Go. Question number three. The senses, the five senses. One of them is sight. One of them is smell. What are these two? You need to write the whole word, whole word. Two of the senses, what are they? Please write them down. Question number four. What toy did Jewish children play with at Hanukkah? Question number five. An object that does not let light shine through it is called what? What do we call it when light cannot pass through something? And number six, what shape is a football? Tough spelling, but you can do it. Well done, year one. Another good week, another positive week. Keep it going. Ow. Hello, year two. Retrieval again. Books ready. Nice sharp pencils. Here we go. Question number one. Please write down the answers to these. Question number two. What does the word stowaway mean? You need to write a full sentence, capital S. Sorry, capital A. A stowaway is full stop, go. Question number three. Please write an expanded noun phrase about assembly. So I need a determiner, two adjectives, separated by a comma, and then a noun at the end. Off we go. Question number four. What does the word pop in pop art stand for? What does it mean? Question number five. Why did the big bird laugh at the little birds? I'm gonna let you start off with because. Why did the big bird laugh at the little birds? And you can start off with because, full stop. I'll let you start off with that. It's not a full sentence, but saves us time. And number six, look at these words. I've joined them up because I came into year two yesterday and lots of children in Maple weren't joining, which we know they can. So, can you please write these words in the past tense? Past tense. Right, well done. Finish up to number zero. Now remember, I got you to do something strange in your learning logs. I got you to do a zero and a gap. So here, next to zero, you need to write a list. You need to write five things that you know about Evel Knievel. Five things you know about him. They don't have to be sentences. They could just be words. But I want five things about Evel Knievel. Off you go. Have a great weekend, year two. You've worked hard this week. Oh yes, year three, here we go. Whew. Number one, it's got two parts. First part, which number is missing from this? 6 times 3 is equal to 5 times 3, add what? That's the first part. The second part, which you write next to, is I want to know if this is true or false. It's
it true or false? Write down true or false.
Number two. The Bronze Age started how many years ago?
Got a clue, it's one of these. How many years ago did the Bronze Age start? Write it down.
Question number three.
Please write down the word which is not an adverb. Which one is not an adverb?
Question number four.
Two parts. First part.
Window, sun, and sunglasses.
You've got to pick the light source. That's the first bit. Window, sun, sunglasses. Which one of those is a light source? Second part, write a sentence about that word. Tell me something about that word that I maybe don't know. Pick the light source, window, sun, or sunglasses. Pick the one, write me a sentence. Go, capital, full stop, go.
Question number five. Which fear did Laszlo overcome?
Write it down.
And question number six. What are the names of the three stitches that we have been doing in class? Write down the three stitches, put a comma in between them, please. And finally, zero, as we know, bit of a tricky space there. So
you should have zero up here, so you should have a line.
You're going to list five things that you know about Evel Knievel. Five things.
Start at the top, write something there, 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 there.
You don't have to use sentences, you can use words, but go, five things. Well done, year three. Weekend's coming up. Enjoy. Hey, year four. Nearly fell over then. I'm trying to be clever. Right, let's go. Retrieval. Sharp pencils, pens. Come on. Question number one. I've been a bit mean here. Sorry. You've got to write down the answer to all of these. It's all number one.
So write down the first answer, do a comma. Write down the second answer, do a comma. Third answer, comma, fourth. Go.
Question number two. Name the part of the ear which is at the end of your ear canal. Question number three, spell question. Question number three, spell question. Go. Question number four, what does devour mean? Full sentence, capital D. Devour means full stop. Go. Question number five, what is 30 in French? Then write down what number three is in French. So 30 in French, and then number three in French. Go. Question number six. Which city was destroyed by Mount Vesuvius in 79 AD? Capital letter, please. Correct spelling. Go. And finally, question zero. Bit of a tricky one this week because I've given you lots of space. Go up to zero.
You got five lines here.
You need to write down five things that you know about Evel Knievel. They don't have to be sentences, but they could be. Five things about Evel Knievel. Five different things. Go. Have a good weekend. Feels like it's going to be the best. Whoa, cheeky move. Year five, here we go. It's going to be good, I know it. Retrieval, get your pens, pencils ready. I've been a bit cheeky with these questions. I've ramped them up a little bit, Mrs. Walden, Mrs. Bradbury, sorry. Number one,
Name the different types of Sikh festivals. Write as many as you can. Go, number one. Number two, what are the answer to these? Now, you need to write down the first answer next to number two, then do a comma, write down the second answer, then do a comma, write the third answer. Three answers next to number two. Question number three, you've got four answers to give. First answer, comma, second answer, comma, third answer, comma, fourth answer. Go. Tough. Question number four. What were the three qualities needed to vote in ancient Athens? What, name the three. Go. Question number five. Sticking with number three again, the power of three. Name three adverbs, or list three adverbs of possibility. Question number six. In science, we designed an investigation into the conditions that affect what? And question zero to finish. Up to the top. One to six. Here's your zero. I'd like you to list, I'd like you to write down five things you know about Evel Knievel. They could be sentences, they might be words. Five things about Knievel, go. Have a great weekend, Year 5. See you Monday. Hello, Year 6. End of the week. Almost there. Let's go. Pens, pencils, books. Come on. Retrieval number one. Please, can you finish off this sentence? You do not need to write this bit. You start after the semicolon. Finish that off, please. Question number two. What are the two main groups that the animal kingdom is split into, and how are those groups subdivided? Two groups of the animal kingdom, and how are they subdivided? Go. Question number three, you've got to write two words down. Relevant and relevance. Relevant, relevance, go. Question four. Globalization is the increasing what? Globalization is the increasing what? Between p and p. What are those three words? Globalization is the increasing what? Between p and p. Off you go. Question number five. Can you name the major changes that resulted from the Industrial Revolution? Write them down, please. Off we go. And question number six. I've had a bit of a disaster with this. Mrs. Campbell was writing it down and she made a mistake. So she put a line through it and said, please look on the other side of the page. But by that time, I'd stuck the page in my book, so I'm not sure if there was anything on the other side, Mrs. Campbell, but I've basically had a shocker. So I'm giving this one to children to do. Number six, choose a number for the top, choose a number for the bottom. Write the answer, go. And question number zero, this is your last one. Gone a bit funky today. Find your zero. You've got five lines. You need to write down five things about Evel Knievel. They do not need to be sentences. They could be a list. Five different things. Go. Have a great weekend, Year 6. Well done on that retrieval, everyone. Now, phone calls with staff. As I've already said, it's not a phone call this week. It's the aftermath of last week's phone call. This will all be explained again in the video. But I had a chat with Mrs. Campbell. She was desperate to take loads of photos of her and her family all dressed up like Evel Knievel. Here we go. It's phone calls with staff, the aftermath. Phone calls with staff, the aftermath. It's phone calls with staff, the aftermath. It's phone calls with staff, the aftermath. Anyway, talking of fondness, are you still a big fan of Evel Knievel after all those assemblies? I can see the look on your face when you see them. You love it, don't you, Mrs. Campbell? Come on.
You know I am. Am I still allowed to do that special tribute next week?
That special tribute? You mean the one where you take 60 photos of you and your family all doing chores around the house, going for walks, washing the car, doing schoolwork, all in Evel Knievel tops?
Great. My family will be so happy.
I knew it. I knew they would. Phone calls with staff, the aftermath. It's phone calls with staff, the aftermath. It's phone calls with staff, the aftermath. Oh, Mrs. Campbell! That video brings joy to my life and other people's. Right, straight into shout outs. We're going to start off with year six house captains. Now, all of these children and many more applied to be house captains for this year. Remember, we've got house captains for Dahl, Rowling, it's very exciting, Morpurgo, and King Smith. We're now going to find out who they are. We're going to meet them, and then I'm going to award them their badges off screen. Right, first of all, let's meet our Rowling house captains for this year. In you come. We've got Isabel and Rufus. Congratulations, both of you. Off you go. Next up, we have the Morpurgo house captains. In you come. From Morpurgo this year, we have Bella, come in a bit Bella, we have Bella and Matthew. Off you go, you two, great work. Now, who have we got for King Smith? Let's find out. In you come. For King Smith House this year, we have Malik and Heather. Off you go, you two, well done. And for Dahl this year, in you come, we've got Matty and we've got Evie, who I'm going to show you a photo of now. She's not here at the moment, But I'm sure many of you will recognise her from around school. Off you go, Matty. Right, well done to those house captains. I'm sure they're going to represent their houses in this school magnificently this year. I'm now going to award them their badges, but before I do that, let's get ready for birthdays. No birthdays today. We had a couple yesterday and we've got a couple at the weekend, but none today. At the weekend, we have Rory in foundation stage and Jack Page in year five. Have a great day, everyone. Boys, enjoy, especially when you got the day off school. Tell me about it on Monday. One more shout out before miss time. Juniper class, Mrs. Williams and Mrs. Gavigan have asked me to say you have been fantastic in your phonics the last few weeks. You've made so much progress, you're learning lots of new sounds, you're doing much better reading and writing. Keep it going, you're brilliant. The most important 60 seconds are coming up now. The most important 60 seconds are coming up now. Yesterday we spoke about Pobat. I got some great pictures of a Pobat actually. Please remember, every time you wash your hands, soap and a little bit of water. For 20 seconds you need to do palms, over the top, between your fingers, backs of your fingers, and your thumbs and your wrists, and then the tips of your fingers. Please remember that every time, it's really important. Last part of the most important 60 seconds is home learning. Oh, reading every day, writing in your learning log when you do, quizzing when it's time, phonics and spelling practice, and times tables, rock stars or numbots. Do you want to be the only child in your class who hasn't done it? Or the one of only two or three? I really don't want you to be. I want the whole class to be in the same routine. Please try and do it this weekend if you haven't, because it will count when I do the checks next week. Come on!